Thanks for choosing this tutorial. In this video, we'll learn to add and control a camera in the 3D viewport. We'll also learn about materials using the Principled BSDF Shader and how to apply them to objects in Blender 3.6. Start by saving the scene to ensure you don't lose any progress. To enhance the realism of our scene, we can add a plain mesh as the ground. By doing so, the object we want to apply a texture to will have a more convincing appearance with the presence of caustics and reflections on the ground. To do this, press Shift plus A to open the Add menu and click on Mesh, followed by Plane. Scale the surface of the plane by pressing S and using the mouse scroll wheel to adjust its size according to your preference. In order to test different material settings, let's add a new object to the scene. We'll use the Suzanne monkey head as it has a more complex topology and will be ideal for this tutorial. To move the object, you can use the shortcut keys G plus an axis for grab, R plus an axis for rotate, and S for scale. Now you can position and scale the object as desired. Position the plane under the object you want to add a material to. To move the object up and down, press G and then Z to constrain the movement to the Z-axis. Leave a small gap of space between the two objects. To add a camera to the scene, press Shift plus A and select Camera from the menu. Ensure that the camera is selected within the scene collection, located to the right of the 3D viewport. Open the viewport sidebar by pressing N and click on the view panel. Disable the Camera to View setting to prevent the camera from following the viewport's perspective. Enter the camera by pressing the camera toggle button to the right of the viewport. Adjust the position and orientation of the camera frame by pressing Shift and holding down the middle mouse button. This allows you to navigate the camera's view independently. Re-enable the Camera to View option in the sidebar. Move the camera to look at the object by pressing G and then the desired axis, Z, X, or Y. Additionally, you can use Shift plus the mouse scroll wheel. This allows you to position the camera to capture the desired view of the object. Select the object you want to give a material to. In the Material Properties tab, click on New to create a new material for the object. Give the material a name that identifies its purpose or appearance. Here's a detailed explanation of each setting within the Principled BSDF node. Set the base color of the material by clicking on the color bar next to Base Color. Subsurface refers to light scattering beneath an object's surface, simulating how light interacts with translucent materials like skin or wax. Unlike opaque surfaces, subsurface materials allow light to penetrate and scatter within, creating a soft, diffused appearance. Subsurface radius. This parameter controls how far light scatters beneath an object's surface. A larger radius value results in deeper light penetration, enhancing subsurface scattering. Subsurface color defines the color of light that scatters beneath the surface. By adjusting this color, you can control the hue of the scattered light, affecting the overall appearance of the material. Subsurface IOR. It controls light bending within a material's subsurface. Higher values increase refraction and pronounced scattering, while lower values reduce bending and subtle scattering. Subsurface anisotropy controls the directionality of subsurface scattering. A value of 0 results in an isotropic scattering pattern, while non-zero values introduce anisotropic behavior, causing light to scatter preferentially in specific directions. Metallic. This setting determines the object's metallic behavior. A value of 0 indicates a non-metallic material, while a value of 1 represents a fully metallic surface, with a mirror-like reflection of light. Specular. Controls the intensity of specular highlights, which are bright reflections of light on the surface of the material. Specular tint. This setting allows you to tint the color of the specular reflections. By adjusting the tint, you can introduce a subtle color cast to the highlights. Roughness specifies the surface roughness of the material. A value of 0 indicates a perfectly smooth surface with sharp reflections, while a value of 1 represents a completely rough surface with diffused reflections. Anisotropic. When enabled, this setting creates an anisotropic material, resulting in elongated specular highlights that align with the direction of the underlying geometry. Anisotropic rotation. This setting rotates the direction of anisotropic reflections, allowing you to control the orientation of the elongated specular highlights on the material's surface. Sheen adds a soft, velvet-like reflection to the material, contributing to its overall appearance. Sheen tint modifies the color of the sheen effect. By adjusting this value, you can introduce a specific hue to the sheen reflection. Clear coat simulates a clear protective coating on top of the material. Clear coat roughness. Higher values result in a rougher appearance, with blurry reflections. IOR, or index of refraction, controls how light interacts with transparent materials. It affects both specular and transmission properties, simulating materials like glass or water. Transmission. This setting simulates the behavior of light passing through transparent or translucent materials. It affects how much light is absorbed or transmitted by the material. Transmission roughness controls the roughness of the transmission effect. Higher values introduce more scattering and blurring of transmitted light, mimicking the appearance of rough or frosted surfaces. Emission. When enabled, this setting allows the material to emit light, turning it into a light source within the scene. Adjust the emission color to determine the hue and intensity of the emitted light. Alpha adjusts the material's transparency. A value of 1 indicates complete opacity, while decreasing the value makes the material increasingly transparent. That's it. Now you know how to add a camera, ground plane, and simple materials to objects in Blender. If you want to learn how to create better textures in Blender and things like glass or physics, then don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials like this one.